Don't climb ladders. Yeah, you've done it. Yeah, don't basically no gutters, outdoor housework at all.
Just enjoy the wind. 6:44. Speaking of that, here's weather. All right, there we go. Our Capital Federal Savings City View camera, and it is bouncing around a little bit in our breeze out there. Garbage can alert kind of day. Make sure everything is secure before you leave the house. West winds 20 to 30. Gusting up to 40. It's just not a good day for raking or cleaning out the gutters, like we were saying, because the winds will be pretty strong. And you get up on a ladder, it can be kind of a dangerous situation on a day like this. 47 degrees. Pressure's rising. That's good news. It was very, very low yesterday as this massive storm kind of barrels through the Midwest. And that's part of the reason it's been so powerful for parts of the country, including the blizzard-like conditions in North Dakota and the severe thunderstorm potential now in the Ohio Valley, Indiana in particular. But now the pressure's starting to go back up for us here in Kansas City. So if you have headaches, migraine headaches, sinus headaches, this should be a fairly comfortable stretch here for the next 2, 3, 4 days. You can see it's quiet rain-wise, certainly. 30% chance of showers Sunday morning. There's some information coming into the Weather Center that doesn't have any rain on Halloween at all, but right now we're just keeping that morning chance there. Maybe a little soggy heading off to church or for tailgating. And then Monday, there's a 30-40% chance again. That's not a sure bet either. So we'll watch that. It's a week away. All right, here's what we're watching today. Of course, there are blizzard conditions or potential for that in western North Dakota. It is right here. It stretches really all the way from Indiana down into the Southland, including parts of the Tennessee Valley, for a slight risk of severe weather. Then there's a moderate risk over a big chunk of the Ohio Valley, and then a high risk in Indiana itself, the entire state, for tornadoes and hail and gusty winds. That's going to be a major outbreak of severe weather there as this storm system barrels to the east. 68 degrees in Chicago with storms, 78 degrees in Memphis. So there's some warm air. See how that warm air has kind of surged up into parts of Indiana and Illinois and Kentucky. So there's some warm, kind of muggy air in place. For us, we're at 47, 38 in Denver, and 26 in Santa Fe. So we're into that cooler, drier, more stable air mass now. How about airport delays? We've been watching this one carefully all day, all morning, I should say. Chicago's still an hour or more delay. That's going to slow a lot of people down out of O'Hare and Midway. And then in D.C., there's about a 30 to 45 minute delay there. So remember, we keep a close eye on that as we make the switch at 7 o'clock to First News KCWE to get you where you need to go on a Tuesday. All right, here's tonight's lows down to 43 degrees, 42 in Kansas City, 38 in Lawrence, 39 in Maryville. Thought we might have a freezing morning this week. Does not appear that that's going to be the case, but we will get to 38 Thursday morning, 37 Friday morning, and then Saturday 70 degrees, a little warm up before that next slight chance of rain does cool us down. 64. It looks like a great Halloween Eve for everybody. It'll be busy out there, so go slow in the neighborhoods. On Monday, we cool down to about 62, but one of those perfect temperature kind of Halloweens. It's not going to be so hot that you're miserable. It's not going to be so cold that you have to wear a jacket over your costume. And we really shouldn't have any rain to worry about. So pretty good trick-or-treating weather, I do believe.